Hi everyone. So I just got back from a walk with my doggies and my husband. So I don't want to do too much effort on my hair. So I'm just gonna do a top knot. Okay. The ends still look half decent. So I'm gonna braid the front of my hair. Taking three pieces and then taking another piece as I go under, taking another piece, putting that piece under. So it's like doing a braid, but like way harder. Sorry guys, I make it look really easy, but I just know how to do it. And I practice a lot. Okay, I'm gonna have to do that over. Do over. See, my arms start to kill when they're up for that long because of obviously what I do for work. So there's my three strands, and I'm going to take one and grab another piece. There's my other strand, take another piece and add it with it. Another strand, take another piece and add it with it. And then I keep kind of doing that as I go up the back. And then I need a break, because my arms hurt. Okay, we're almost done, we're almost done. And then I just take it and braid the remainder. But my arms are so weak. Well, my shoulders are so weak. And then I'm going to just take and kind of pull out the pieces of the braid, which my braid is not perfect by any means right now, but that's okay. And then I'm just going to wrap it and take the tail and kind of stick it through. And then, that's my tail. Bobkin that sucker. And I'm probably going to use like a million bobby pins because then I open it up to give it like a little bit of a shape and then I bobby pin it into place. And like I know it's going to look messy, but it's supposed to. There you go. There's a messy top knot. I don't know what this piece is, so I'll tuck them away. Easy, right? Come on. Then any weird pieces that are sticking up, I'll just take a bobby pin and hide it. Look at that. And if it looks black, I just take another bobby pin. Perfect. Alright, so I have some exciting, hopefully exciting news. Well, first of all, I slept with the coconut oil on my face last night and feels great. Besides that, I'm looking to bring in a makeup line, obviously, that I can believe in and trust and work with and obviously sell to you guys. So I found one, I think, that I really like. So my friend gave me a bunch of stuff to try from it. So I'm going to start. Oh, thanks, Maria. So this is my MAC Painterly Eyeshadow Primer. This company actually has their own eyeshadow primer, just saying, which I used a little bit yesterday. So I'm kind of excited because it's definitely way more affordable than some of the makeup that I show you guys. And it's super high quality. And I get to pick what colors I want to sell, and I get to repackage them and sell them in my name, so it's kind of exciting. But my friend gave me some to play with, so I'm going to play with the pigments. I want to see how pigmented they are, because we all know I'm psycho about pigment. So what do we got? She gave me like, she's like, I'm just gonna throw this out. I'm like, hell no you aren't. I'm taking that home, girl. Okay, so let's play. So I'm gonna use this teal color and this one. So the teal will be my dark, and then my light will be that one. And I'm just gonna drop like 30 of them. Okay. Let me find a brush. Oh shit, I left my thing downstairs again. Okay. So this is the teal color from the makeup line that I'm hoping to work with. Pretty. So it goes on nice, and there's not a ton of overfall, which is great. And they have their own makeup brushes, so I'm excited. And they make liquid lipsticks. Yeah, so the pigment is on point. And it's not all down here. Look at it. A little bit, but not like my friggin' expensive palettes. So the pigment's great. I'm gonna take a little bit of that and run it underneath. I'm pretty impressed. More so than I thought I would be, not gonna lie. I'm kind of a picky person. Okay. I left my makeup wipes downstairs because I suck. So, a little bit of a towel and some toning spray, and just to make sure I don't have any blue. You know, that's nothing compared to if I had used one of my other palettes, so that is pretty bomb. So now I'm going to use the light color, which is a shimmery version. This one has a little shimmer too. So far, so good. I'm going to take a little bit of that color and also put it in the inside corner. And then I'm going to clean my brush and make sure to blend. Blend it out. So I'm going to take that same light color that I used and just use that as a brow highlight. Ed Valerie in the house. What up, Ed V? So I'm pretty happy so far with the quality of the makeup, which is great because it's been really hard to find eyeshadow that I felt was pigmented enough for me. And it comes in an array of colors, so I get to choose which ones I want to sell, which is great. So then I'm just doing some liquid eyeliner. So liquid liner is on, and now we all know Monistat Chafe and Relief Powder Gel as a primer. Get it. Phew. Oh, meh. I knew my, there's nothing worse than sneezing when you are doing your makeup. All right, so Monistat Chafing Relief Gel is where it is at for makeup primer. So if you don't have it, go get it. You can buy it online at Amazon. Right, Sarah? It's the best. You can buy it on Amazon for $5.98. I'm sure they sell it at Walmart and all that. But I just sneezed and ruined my liquid eyeliner, so I gotta blend that. I guess it could have been worse. It could have been mascara. I couldn't even hold the sneezing. Okay, disaster averted. So now I'm going to do some tinted moisturizer. I'm going to be using the Aveda one for now. It is in Sweet Tea. Putting it right over my Monistat. And I'm using my Rihanna brush from her Fenty collection. This is her foundation brush. I do feel like it blends foundation and tinted moisturizer very, very well. So it was the one thing I did not return from her collection. I'm definitely a tinted moisturizer or BB cream with powder over it person. I'm not a huge foundation wearer unless I'm gonna like go hard and I know I'm gonna be sweating like a wilder beast, which happens. Then I'll go in with like an actual foundation, but for the most part, I'm super fortunate to have pretty good skin, so I don't necessarily have a lot to cover. I just have like a birthmark here. It's like a red thing that I cover. The tinted moisturizer is usually good enough to cover that. So then I'm going to go in with my MAC NC35 powder. And just throw that on top. And I will take like a brush and kind of go a little closer to my eyes with it. But that way you don't look cakey. It just sits on your skin really nice, especially when you put the Monistat under it. I know it seems weird, guys, but put some Monistat on your face. Alright, so then I'm going to use my L'Oreal Lash Intenso mascara. Yeah, but I'm super excited about this makeup, you guys, because I haven't found anything that I wanted to put my name on that is pigmented enough to sell you guys or has all of the things that I use. So I'm super excited to start playing with this new line that I found. And it's not like any of the ones that you guys have heard. It'll be packaged under my name. It's not, you know, some of the multi-level sales stuff. Because I'm not a firm believer in all those products, so I need to find something that I believe in all the products. And so far, the eyeshadow is a go. Which I find that eyeshadow is the hardest thing for me to really like from companies. I like pigmented stuff. I like it to look blue. If it's meant to be blue, it needs to look damn blue. Alright, so now I'm just going to clean up my eyebrows. This is a cheapy pencil I got. Revlon Colorstay. I wanted to see what the I like high-end makeup, but not everybody can afford it. So I think it's time to start playing. To see if I notice if there's a huge difference. And I hate to say it, there's not a huge difference so far in a lot of the high-end stuff that I use. One huge difference between this eyeshadow line that I'm hoping to start carrying under my name is it doesn't fall like all my other crap. I usually have more eyeshadow under my eyes than on my eyes. Hi, Stephanie. So now I just blend that in. And then I'm going to put some blush on. My husband has lunch ready for me, so it's going to kill me. So I will be quick. Blush, blush, blush. Where you at? Where you at? I'll go with the Foxglove by Becca. It's super bright. Thanks, girl. I'm going to start, I think I might start selling my own makeup line, and this is part of it. So this blush is crazy pigmented, so you only need a little. Like, I definitely put too much on. And that brush is not my fave. Yeah, I'm just gonna have to go and sit down with the company and figure out what colors I want to have under my line, which is pretty sweet. I never thought that could be a thing, but it is, my friends. And it's affordable. It's not friggin' $35 for lip stuff or $30 for mascara, because ain't nobody got time for all that. Alright, so I'm gonna do a lip. La 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 la. What do I do? What should I do? What should I do? I'm gonna have to redo it because I'm gonna eat, but they'll do. Yeah. Alright, this is Aisha from Kat Von D. And now I look like a mermaid. I can't wait to try the company's liquid lipsticks. I know, right? I love makeup, I always have, but it's hard to do makeup and then not make any business from it. I think I found a way. All right. So that is today's look. It's a Little Mermaid-esque, which I'm down for. I got my top knot. Eyes on fleek, lips on fleek, brows on fleek. I will catch you guys tomorrow. Hi, Lena. Oh no, I'm not working tomorrow. So you might not see me tomorrow. But I will see you guys soon. Love you guys. Have a great weekend. Bye. Get outside. It's beautiful.